A day after firing Secretary of State Rex Tillerson by tweet, sources say President Trump isn't finished with his West Wing shakeup. The president is expected to get rid of even more staffers he's said to have clashed with and surround himself with people more aligned with his style and populist agenda.
I'm really at a point where we're getting very close to having the cabinet and other things that I want.
The president isn't happy with several of his remaining cabinet members. Veterans Affairs Secretary David Shulkin over poor management and misuse of taxpayer money, National Security Advisor H.R. McMaster over areas of foreign policy, Interior Secretary Ryan Zinke over excessive spending on travel, EPA Administrator Scott Pruitt over using pricey hotels and planes, HUD Secretary Ben Carson over that $31,000 dining set, Education Secretary Betsy DeVos after a poor performance in a recent television interview, Attorney General Jeff Sessions over the Russia investigation, and even his chief of staff, John Kelly, for trying to exert too much control over the West Wing, leaving many wondering who's next to go.
This is the Kudlow Report.
Now Trump has offered economist and TV personality Larry Kudlow the role of chief economic advisor after Gary Cohn resigned over a disagreement on tariffs, something Kudlow and the president also disagreed over.
I've known him a long time. We don't agree on everything, but in this case, I think that's good. I want to have a divergent opinion.
Meanwhile, the blame game over the special election in Pennsylvania begins, a race widely seen as a test of the president's political clout, with sources close to the White House blaming the Republican Rick Saccone for being a, quote, weak candidate. Democrats have already declared victory over Saccone, with Connor Lamb holding a slight lead.
It took a little longer than we thought, but we did it.
Trump carried the district by nearly 20 points in 2016 and held a rally alongside Saccone ahead of Tuesday's race. The White House now saying Lamb won because he embraced the president's policies.
The public polling wasn't looking so good, and the president came in and helped close this race and got it to where it is right now, which is, you know, within a few hundred votes.
But at their private caucus meeting, the chairman of the National Republican Congressional Committee warned lawmakers, this is a wake-up call. A sentiment echoed by some members.
If you just simply go to try to run on the, you know, say the president's coattails or the national environment, you could get swept up and swept out.